Working with TopSolid'Cam 7 is easy for any user. Here, you see that the interface adapts itself to various screen resolutions. Next, we'll show you how easy it is to filter through different cutting tools and holders. Just pick on the image of the type of tool you're looking for, and TopSolid does the rest. Here, we'll show you how easy it is to add a new end mill. A wizard will launch, and in this wizard, you can just type the values for your diameter and flute length, shankla a diameter, and overall length. Choose a number of teeth and specify the cutting material, and you're now good to go and ready to use this cutting tool. But maybe you want to adjust the holder itself. For example, maybe you want to make it smaller. And like that, your work here is complete. But that's not the only thing that's dynamic inside of TopSolid'Cam 7. In fact, all of the 2.5 axis toolpath is dynamic as well. Here you see, as we change various settings within the operation, the toolpath is dynamically updating to the right. Let's maybe change the engagement of the cutter to be 100% of the diameter. And boom, it's done just like that. Let's change to spiral. Again, the update is almost instantaneous. Let's see what it would look like if we turned on alpha loops. Or how about if we use tricordial machining? Gone is the day where you have to calculate your toolpath just in order to see if the result is what you were looking for. Now you see a simulation being run of the real material removal process. On top of that, we'll even show you a simulation of your CNC control. And like that, you can get a really good feeling of what your toolpath is going to do and how it might react on your machine. Finally, we'll show you a simulation of the full machining environment, and we're doing this in three separate views so that you can quickly see if there are any collisions.